my name is Diana. I'm here to teach yoga for you from the Orem Rec Center, well, the Senior Friendship Center, in lieu of all the craziness. So if you've got a block and a strap, get started. So go ahead and have a seat. You're on your block, you want to sit on the edge of your block so that your hips roll forward, allowing your hips to soften. Bring your hands out to your sides, bring your palms toward the ceiling. Take a nice deep inhale, draw your hands up over your head, stretch your fingertips toward the ceiling. Open your mouth and exhale, release all of your breath, gently tap your mat at the bottom of your exhale. Inhale and lift. Exhale and lower. One more time, inhale, lift. Pause here. Stretch a little bit longer, feel your right side come a little bit taller, your left side come a little bit longer, and then release both hands down to your thighs, palms up or palms down, whichever is more comfortable. Your shoulders pull back and down. You can soften or close your eyes down. Relax your hips. Just begin to turn your focus inward, letting go of your thoughts. Try not to worry about what you need to do later, what's going on. Just try to focus on your breath. Pay attention to this space. Let your shoulders get a little heavier. Keep your chin parallel to your mat. Your jaw stays soft. Your eyes are soft. Your belly relaxes as you begin to deepen your breath. Noticing where your breath is. If your breath is high up into your chest, try to move it down into your belly. Feel your breath in your diaphragm. And then try to hear your breath. Moving your breath through your throat and your nose. Moving through an ujjayi breath. If you've never done ujjayi breathing before, it's kind of like fogging up a mirror with your lips closed. Trying to create a soft whispering breath as your breath moves through your nose and your throat. And keep your jaw soft. Chin stays parallel to your mat, bringing your awareness back to your breath. Muscles in your face are soft. Your hips are heavy. As you begin to deepen your breath, coming to a 4 to 5 count inhale, 4 to 5 count exhale. Your breath in your belly, finding softness as you exhale, keeping length in your spine as you inhale, noticing that space in the back of your neck. Trying to stay with a 4 to 5 count inhale, a 4 to 5 count exhale. Try to control your breath. Continuing to quiet your mind. Take 2 more rounds of breath here. Make any adjustments that you need. Try to find softness. On your next inhale, lengthen through your spine, stretch through the crown of your head. Exhale as you drop your right ear to your right shoulder. Your left shoulder gets a little heavier. Maybe adjust your neck a little bit. Allow the muscles in your face to soften. Both shoulders to get heavy. And then bring your awareness back to that yoga breath. On your next inhale, bring your head back to center. Exhale as you tip your head the opposite direction. Feeling the weight of your right shoulder, adjusting your neck, allowing your hips to release. Notice your breathing. On your next inhale, bring your head back to center. Exhale as your chin drops to your chest, keeping your spine long, feeling that space in the back of your neck. Notice the weight of your head. Slowly begin to move your chin from right to left across your chest. Your shoulders heavy, slowly increasing the range of motion. Next time your chin moves to the right, bring your right ear to your shoulder.
Your throat opens, your shoulders stay heavy.
On your next exhale, drop your chin back down across your chest, move it to the opposite side. Inhaling as your left ear comes to your left shoulder, your throat opens, your shoulders stay soft. Notice if you're breathing. On your next exhale, drop your chin back down to the center. Sit up a little bit taller, walk your hands behind you, press your hands into your mat or your block, open through your chest.
Feel your chest open, maybe take a deep breath from behind your heart.
Inhale as you come back to center, keep your hands behind you, lean into your hands, switch your legs, bring the opposite leg forward. You can stay up on your block or roll down off your block. Bringing your hands back to your knees, sit up nice and tall, pull your shoulders back and down. Draw your hands back out to your sides as you inhale. And on your next inhale, draw your hands up over your head. Reach toward the ceiling. Stretch nice and tall. Clasp your fingers together. Flip your palms. Press your palms toward the ceiling. Relax your shoulders. Draw your arms back a little bit out of your peripheral. Keep your chin parallel to the mat. And on your next inhale, unclasp your hands. Your elbows stay parallel to your shoulders as you open through your chest. Drop your hands down to your mat, lean into the right hand as you extend your left hand up toward the ceiling. And as you exhale, bend toward the right. Chest stays facing forward, hips stay soft. Kind of breathe into the side of your body, feel it coming up and over like you're trying to open up through your ribs. If your shoulder is pulled up toward your ear, try to pull your shoulder away from your ear. Continue with your breath. On your next inhale, come back to center, drop your left hand to your mat, stretch your right hand up toward the stomach. Exhale as you bend toward the left. Keeping your right hip grounded, shoulders pull away from your ears. Notice if you're breathing. Trying to find an even breath, 3 to 4 count inhale, 3 to 4 count exhale. Inhale as you come back to center, extend both hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale as you lower your hands in front of you, clasp your fingers together, flip your palms, drop your head round through your back, pull your belly in, try to feel that breath in your upper back. Feel like you're expanding your shoulder blades away from each other as you inhale. Inhale, bring your hands back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, release your hands down to your sides, walk your hands behind you, lean into your hands again as you open through your chest, come into a little bit of a back bend. Maybe open and close your mouth a few times to stretch through the front of your throat. Inhale, come back to center. Lean into your hands, unwind your legs, extend your legs out in front of you, gently tap the backs of your knees. Slide your left foot to the inside of your right thigh, either above or below your knee, you don't want it right on your knee. Hands come to your sides, gently rock back and forth a few times, find your sit. Reach over, grab onto your strap. Then bring the strap around the ball of your foot. Grab both sides of the strap. Once you get here, try to relax that bending. Pull your shoulders back and down, sit up nice and tall. Press through your heel, feel that stretch in the back of your leg. And then gently lean forward. Feel your ribs come toward your thighs, your shoulders get a little heavier. Feel that space in the back of your neck. You don't want to drop your head and you don't want to look too high. And then bring your awareness to your breath. Find softness in your shoulders. That bent leg stays soft. Your belly relaxes. Your breath stays even. Feel the sensation of your breath in your lower back. Finding that softness with each exhale. On your next breath, grab both sides of that strap with your left hand. Shoulders come back over your hip as you twist toward the right. Keep a hold of that strap on your extended leg. Keep your foot flexed. Your Chest faces toward the right side, your shoulders soften. If you want more of a twist, you can extend that back arm toward the back of the room. Just make sure you can breathe. Make sure that left leg doesn't get too tight. Find that yoga breath. 3 to 4 count inhale, 3 to 4 count exhale. One more breath here, maybe soften your shoulders. Maybe smile. Come back to center, grab both sides of that strap with your right hand. This time your left hand comes to your hip as you twist toward the left. Keeping that extended foot flexed. Your shoulders line up over your hips, your chest faces the opposite side of the room. You want to extend that back arm toward the back of the room to get more stretch, deeper stretch in your shoulders. Just make sure you can breathe. At any time, if you're holding your breath, you're probably trying too hard. Relax your shoulders. Inhale, come back to center. Grab both sides of that strap again. Sit up nice and tall. Push your heel toward the front of the room and then gently fold forward again. So if you can find a little bit more length in that hamstring. Try to deepen your breath to find softness. It's your inhale that tightens and your exhale that softens. Feel that space in the back of your neck. More deep inhale, find a little bit more length in your spine. Exhale as you find a little more softness. Inhale, come back to center, let your strap drop. Bring your left hand to the floor. We're going to lift and open up through your chest as you come onto your knee. Open, feel your chest open, press your foot into your mat. Take a deep breath here. Maybe smile again. And then lower back down as we switch sides. Nice job. Pull your left foot into, or your right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Grab your strap again. Flex your heel toward the front of the room. Pull your shoulder blades back and down. Make sure that right leg is soft now. And as you exhale, slowly begin to fold forward. Relax your shoulders. Feel that stretch in the back of your leg into your hamstring. Feel that length of your spine. Pull your shoulders away from your ears. Release your jaw. Bring your awareness back to your breath. Try to encourage that hamstring to soften. Take two more deep breaths here. Feel that space in the back of your neck. Let your shoulders get a little heavier. And on your next breath, grab both sides of that strap with your right hand. Your shoulders come up over your hips as your left hand comes to your hip and you twist toward the left. Pull your shoulders away from your ears. If you want more of a stretch, you can extend that back arm toward the back of the room or just leave it on your hip. Just make sure you can breathe. More important than you're able to breathe. You don't want to try and force yourself into any of these postures. Put your shoulders away from your ears, relax your jaw. Maybe smile again. Inhale, come back to center. Grab both sides of your strap with your left hand. Twist toward the right as your right hand comes to your hip. Chest faces toward the right. Try to find that length in your spine, softness of your shoulders. Maybe extend that arm back toward the back of the room. Press through that extended leg. Feel your heel press forward. Relax your jaw. Inhale, come back to center. Grab both sides of your strap. Sit up nice and tall again. And then gently fold into that extended leg. Maybe finding a little bit more range of motion. Let go of your shoulders. Feel the softness of your hips. Notice your breath in your lower back. Try to keep that space in the back of your neck so you don't prevent that blood flow or your breath. Take two more deep breaths here. come back to center. Release that strap, move it to the side. And then bring your right hand to the floor next to your right leg. Swing your left arm up and open as you open up through your opposite side. One more breath here. And as you exhale, lower back down. Extend your other leg out, tap the backs of your knees, get that blood flow back into your leg. Then slide your heels underneath you, roll over and make your way to a table. Open your fingers nice and wide on your mat. Your knees are hip width apart, curl your toes under. Pull your shoulders back and down. Try to point your pinky toward the outer edge of your mat and your thumbs in towards each other, creating that space between your fingers. Pull your shoulders back away from your ears, that length in your spine. Deep breath, and as you exhale, round through your spine, drop your head as you come to cat. Feel your belly pull in. Notice the weight of your head as you press the floor away from you with your hands. Take a few deep breaths here and try to feel that breath in your upper back. Noticing the weight of your head, keeping your breath even. On your next inhale, put a sway in your back, look forward, pull your shoulders away from your ears. You don't want to look straight up toward the ceiling. Keep that space in the back of your neck. Feel that curve in your back from the back of your neck to your hips. And on your next exhale, press the floor away from you, round through your spine, drop your head as you press into cat. And as you inhale, switch your spine as you come to cat. Pull your shoulders away from you, look forward. Move back and forth from cat to cow. Warming up your back muscles, getting that synovial fluid moving. Also helping to increase the flexibility of your spine. Try to move with your breath. Try to find that 3-4 count inhale, 3-4 count exhale. On your next inhale, come back to a neutral spine. Slide your right foot to the back of your mat. Walk your left fingertips to the front of your mat so you're up onto your fingertips. Flatten your hips so your hips aren't open. Find your balance. Keep your fingertips on your mat and lift just your leg. Extend your foot toward the back of the room. Make sure your hips are flat so your knee faces toward the floor. Finding your balance, picking up your left hand. Reach forward, reach back. Feel as if somebody has a hold of your wrist and your ankle and is trying to make you longer. Try to keep your lower back flat so you're not opening up through your hip. Press the floor away from you with your right hand on your mat so you're not stressing out your wrist. Exhale, release your knee and hand to your mat. Find your balance. And then we'll go to the other side. Slide your left foot back. Flatten your hips. Walk your right fingertips forward. Press into your fingertips, flatten your back body, find that length in your spine. Pick your left leg up, keep your right fingertips grounded. Press the floor away from you with your right hand and your left hand leg so you aren't sinking into your joints. And then pick that right hand up. Extend your right fingertips forward, your leg back, your hips are flat. Make sure you're breathing. On your next exhale, release your knee and hand to your mat. Maybe wiggle your tail. Slide your right foot back, your left fingertips forward, and then lift your leg and hand to that. Press the floor away from you. Keep that lower back flat. Make sure you can breathe. If you need to drop your hand or your foot to your mat, feel free to drop them to your mat. And on your next exhale, pull your elbow in towards your knee. Knee in towards your elbow as you drop your head and round through your spine. Inhale as you lengthen. Exhale as you draw in. Again, if that's too much on your balance, just go ahead and drop that left hand to your mat. And just focus on bringing that knee in. Make sure you can breathe. The next time you inhale, pause. Drop your left hand to your mat. Keep your right leg lifted. And then cross your right leg over your left leg. Look over your left shoulder to your right foot. And press into your right hand. Feel that stretch in your side body. Pull your shoulders away from your ears and make sure you can breathe. Inhale as that leg comes back behind you. Exhale as you drop your knee to your mat. Take a few movements here, maybe roll through your wrist if it feels a little too much pressure on your wrist. And then when you're ready, slide your left foot back and your right fingertips forward. Flatten your hips. As you inhale, pick your leg and your hand up, making you nice and long. Keep those hips flat like you're trying to balance a glass of water on your lower back. On your next exhale, pull your elbow in towards your knee, round through your spine, drop your head. Inhale, lengthen. Again, if that's too much on your balance, keep both hands on your mat and just focus on drawing that knee in and grounding through your spine. Working on your balance as well as your strength. Inhale as you lengthen. Exhale as you draw in. The next time you inhale, pause. Release your left hand to your mat. Keep your right or your left leg lifted. Cross your left leg over your right. Look over your right shoulder. Press into your left hand. Feel that stretch in the outside of your left. Make sure you're breathing. Feel that space between your ribs. Make shoulders away from your ears. Inhale, bring your leg back behind you. Exhale as you drop your knee to your mat. Bring your big toes together. Open your knees a little wider than your hips. Sit back towards your heels. Come to a child's pose. Walk your hands toward the front of your mat. Push your chin or your forehead into your mat. Feel that stretch in your shoulders. If your wrists are sore, turn your palms toward the ceiling and open up and close your hands a few times. Take a moment here to come back to that 3-4 count inhale, 3-4 count exhale. Two more deep breaths here. Inhale, make your way back to the table. Lock your wrists back under your shoulders. Open your feet hip width apart. Curl your toes under. And as you inhale, pick your knees up off your mat. Keep your knees bent as you press your ribs towards your thighs. Lift your tailbone up toward the ceiling. Press into the floor and let your head hang. Think about the length of your spine. As you inhale, shift your weight forward, float your knees over your mat. So you're in a tabletop that you're just hovering over your mat. Place shoulders away from your ears, make sure you can breathe. Maybe smile. Press back into a modified down dog, ribs pressed towards your thighs. Head hangs heavy, back is nice and long. And then slowly begin to straighten your legs. Coming to a full down dog. Pedal your feet, draw one heel toward the mat as you bend the opposite leg. Try not to lean too far forward in your hands. Keep your tailbone lifted. Doesn't matter if your heels touch the floor, just feel that stretch in your calves. On your next inhale, lift your right leg. Rotate your ankle a few times one direction. And then rotate a few times the opposite direction. Extend that leg behind you. Take a nice inhale. And as you exhale, swing that leg all the way forward, bringing it between your hands. Nice. Dropping down to that back knee once you get here. Once you're here, bring your hands to the top of that front knee and gently press that front knee forward. Pull your shoulders back and down. Feel that stretch in that hip or that hip flexor. Your shoulders are soft. Relax your shoulders. Find that 3-4 count inhale, 3-4 count exhale. On your next breath, drop your hands down, frame that front foot, half straighten that front leg. Peel the ball of your foot up off your mat. Walk your hands back to the outer edges of your shin, and then lean over that front leg. Feeling that stretch in your hamstrings. If you need to bend your leg a little bit more, bend it. It doesn't need to be straight. You want to bend in your knee just to isolate that hamstring, and you don't want to sit back towards that back heel. Try to find that breath in your lower back. On your next inhale, walk your hands back forward to frame that front foot. Peel it. Pick your knee up. Bring that left hand to the outside edge of your mat. You're going to twist toward the right. Bring your hand to your hip. Or if you want to extend your arm up. If that's too much on your legs, drop that back knee to your mat. Press to that back heel if your knee's lifted. Make sure you're breathing. You don't want to hold your breath. As you exhale, release that right hand down to the inside of your right foot. You can keep that knee lifted or release it to your mat. Find your balance, and I'm going to twist to the opposite side so that your hand's going to come to your hip. Twisting to the left, hugging your right arm and your right leg in towards each other. Maybe extending your hand up toward the ceiling. If you feel like you're kinking your neck, try to create space in your neck. Try to find that yoga breath. As you exhale, drop both hands down to the inside of that front foot. If you want, you can use your block to bring it in between, to bring it underneath your hands to bring the floor closer to you. You can stay here if that's a good enough stretch for you. If you want to move deeper, you can drop down onto your forearms. Wherever you are, just make sure you can breathe. If you're holding your breath, you're trying too hard, let your jaw soften. Feel your hips release. Carry a lot of stress and tension in our hips. It's not all in our back and shoulders. Take a few more deep breaths here. Relax your shoulders, relax your jaw. Focus on your exhale. On your next breath, gently begin to come out of the posture. Move your block to the side, heel toe your foot back to center. Curl the toes under your back leg and lift your back knee. And back to that low lunge. And then drag that front foot back. Circle that hip a few times, get that blood flow back into your leg. Then drop your foot back down to the floor for that down dog. Let your head hang heavy, lift through your tailbone. Visualize the length of your spine. Come high onto your toes. Shift your weight forward, come to a high plank. You need to adjust your feet and your hands. Press the floor away from you. This is the space that you want for your down dog. Lift through your tailbone and come back to a down dog. Let your head hang heavy, shoulders pull away from your ears. And on your next breath, pick up your left leg. Rotate your ankle a few times one direction, a few times the opposite direction. Take a big inhale, and as you exhale, swing that leg all the way forward, bringing it between your hands. Moving to a lunge on the opposite side. So if that front knee is pressing over your foot, try to back it up a little bit to line that knee and your ankle. Press to that back heel, feel the strength of your back leg. Pull your shoulders away from your ears. Make sure you can breathe. And on your next exhale, release your knee to the floor. Bring your hands to the top of that front. Gently press your knee forward. Relax your shoulders. Feel that stretch in your opposite hips. Release your jaw. Notice your breathing. Take two more deep breaths here. Find some other area to soften. Maybe it's that back hip. Maybe it's jaw. On your next breath, drop your hands down to frame that front foot, and then gently half straighten that front leg. So you're going to peel the ball of your foot up off your mat, press into your heel, round over that leg. Doesn't matter how far you come forward, just enough for you to feel yourself, feel your hamstring. Let your head hang heavy, your shoulders relax. Make any adjustments that you need. If you need more of a stretch, if you just press, think about pressing that left hip back, you're going to get a deeper stretch into your hamstring.
Again, just make sure you can breathe. Take one more deep breath here. Inhale as you come back to that low lunge.
Curl the toes under
that back foot if they aren't already as you pick up that back knee, or you can leave it to the floor. Walk your right hand to the outside of your mat.
Twist toward the left. Left hand comes to your hip, chest opens. If you want to extend your hand up toward the ceiling, just make sure your head's not back, that you've got that space in the back of your neck. Maybe your belly pulls in. Maybe you smile. On your next exhale, release your left hand to the inside of your left foot. You can keep that right knee lifted or release it to the floor. Find your balance as that right hand comes up toward the ceiling. Just make sure you can breathe. One more deep breath here. As you exhale, drop both hands down to the inside of that left foot. Recenter your hips. Grab your block again if you had it on the other side. Begin to lower down. If that's too much, it's okay to stay up high. There's no rules that say you have to go too far down. It's all about where you are with your body and whether or not you can breathe. Breathing's way more important than being able to force yourself into a posture. Usually when you're holding your breath, it's when you get injured. Relax your shoulders, release your jaw. Find that 3-4 count inhale, 3-4 count exhale. Two more deep breaths here. Find some area to soften. Maybe it's your jaw, maybe it's your shoulders. Gently begin to grab the posture. Move your block to the side if you were using it. Heel toe your foot back to center. Curl the toes under that back leg as you lift through your back knee. When you're ready, slide that left foot back. Circle that hip a few times. Get that blood flow back into your leg. Release that foot to the floor. Realign your down dog. Look at your hands. Your thumbs should point towards each other. Maybe your pinky fingers toward the outer edge of your mat. And as you exhale, release to your knees. Bring your big toes together. Open your knees a little wider than your hips as you sit back towards your heels, coming to a child's pose. Maybe shift your hips from right to left if that feels good. Your chin and your forehead presses towards your mat as your fingertips walk toward the front of your mat. Feel that stretch in your shoulders, that lengthen your spine. Find that even yoga breath. Two more deep breaths here. Relax your jaw. Relax your belly. Inhale, make your way back to a tabletop. Drop down onto your right or left hip. Swing your legs around in front of you. Tap the backs of your knees. Get that blood flow back into your legs. Then bring the soles of your feet together. Pull your heels in towards you. Grab onto your lower shins. Lock your heels in a little closer if you want. You can bring your hands behind you and pick your glutes up and get in closer. Once here, gently rest your elbows on your thighs and just rock your legs back and forth a few times. Reach down, grab onto your feet like a book. Begin to open your feet like a book as you lean forward. Keep that space in the back of your neck, your shoulders pull away from your ears. Don't drop your head, don't round. If right here is as far as your legs will let you go, that's a perfect place to be. Nowhere in yoga does it say you need to lay on the floor. Let your belly soften, shoulders pull away from your ears, and then try to get your hips to soften. A lot of times it's our mind that tightens up. Try to allow those muscles to soften, even if it's just a tiny bit. Inhale, come back to center. Slide your feet a little further out in front of you. A good measuring tool is your elbow to your fingertips to your heels, your elbow into your thighs. And then grab the tops of your feet, sit up nice and tall. Then this time lean as far forward as you can and then drop your head, and it's okay to let your spine round. Again, it doesn't matter how far you come forward, just focus on softening. This is a good position to put any kids in if they're getting a little angry and too cagey this time of year. Helps you to relax, helps to calm people down. Breath here, let your belly soften, your spine get a little bit longer. Take two deep breaths. Try to inhale for four and exhale for five. One more deep inhale. Open your mouth and exhale. On your next inhale, gently begin to come out of the posture. Bring your hands underneath your thighs, bring your legs together, extend your legs back out in front of you, tap the backs of your knees to get that blood flow back into your legs, and then reposition yourself on your mat. We're going to lay all the way down. So bring your hands to the tops of your knees, tuck your chin, wrap through your back, and slowly roll all the way down to the floor, picking your feet up off the floor. When you get down, pull your knees into your chest, let your head and your shoulders rest into your mat, your knees pull tight into your chest. Jaw softens. Maybe feel your chest open. Keep a hold of that right knee and extend your left leg out. Let your left leg come flat on your mat. Right knee pulls in towards your chest. Rotate that ankle a few times one direction. A few times the opposite direction. Bring that leg out to a 90 degree angle. Extend your right arm out on your mat. Reach your left hand to the outside edge of your right leg and gently move into a twist. Try to keep that leg at a 90 degree angle. If your block is close, you can slide your block underneath your foot to land on it. To allow your hips to rest. Just try to keep that right leg at a 90 degree angle. It's a different twist if you have your leg on your left thigh. Keep both shoulders on your mat. Your jaw stays soft. And then bring your awareness back to your breath. 3 to 4 count inhale, 3 to 4 count exhale. Let your belly soften. That bottom leg get a little heavier. Your back teeth are touching, you're probably clenching your jaw. Try to soften your jaw. Take two more deep breaths here. Find some other area to soften. On your next inhale, come back to center. Pull that right knee into your chest. Let it rest to the floor, keeping your knee bent. And then pick that left leg up. Hug your left knee into your chest and then straighten your right leg. Good. Pull your shoulders in. Pull your back into your mat. You don't want to be rolled over to one side or the other. Shoulders press into your mat. If you used your block on the one side, feel free to move it out to the other side. And then when you're ready, move into that twist. Your left arm expands, extends. Your right hand comes to the outside edge of that leg. Try to keep it at a 90 degree angle. Your shoulders both stay on the mat as you gently let that left leg float to the right. If your shoulders have come up off your mat, come out of the posture a little bit and just focus on letting that leg drop. Block under your foot will help your hip to relax. If you want more of a twist, you can look away from your leg. Let that bottom leg get heavy. Belly soften. Try to deepen that yoga breath. Relax your jaw as you find softness as you exhale. Maybe a soft smile there. two more deep breaths here. Find some other area to soften. Maybe it's that bottom foot. Maybe it's your forehead. Maybe it's your eyes. As you inhale, come back to center. Pull that left knee into your chest. Pick your right leg up. Pull both knees into your chest. Bring your knees together, bring your hands to the tops of your knees, and gently circle your knees. Feel like you have a clock or a plate underneath your lower back that you're tracing with your lower back. And then switch and rotate your knees the opposite direction. Bring your knees back to center, hug your knees in tight. Reach down, grab the insides or the outsides of the soles of your feet as you move into happy baby. Feel your knees press toward the outer edges of your chest, that stretch in your hips. If you want a little bit of a back massage, you can gently rock from right to left. Coming back to center. On your next breath, gently bring your legs back down to your mat. Straighten your legs out on your mat. Draw your hands up over your head, stretch your fingertips toward the back of the room. Point your toes, clasp your opposite thumbs, stretch your fingertips toward the back of the room, feel that stretch in your shoulders. Take a couple of deep breaths here, relax your jaw. On your next exhale, gently rest your hands down to your sides. Open your feet a little bit wider than your hips as we prepare for Savasana, the final resting pose of yoga. Let your feet fall open. Your legs are together, it's hard to relax your hips, so try to open your legs just a little bit. Hands are to your sides, maybe turn your palms toward the ceiling as your shoulders soften. Your jaw gets heavy, your eyes relax. Notice the weight of your belly, the weight of your arms. Let your hips soften. Letting go of that yoga breath, coming back to your natural breath. As you take the last few minutes of class, do try to get your mind to stay here. If you feel your mind begin to wander, acknowledge your thoughts, then allow them to drift away as if on a cloud, bringing your awareness back to your body, back to the softness, focusing on the stillness. Mind begins to wander, bring your awareness back to your breath. As you draw your breath in, think the word inhale. As you allow your breath to release, think the word exhale. Slowly begin to deepen your breath. Coming back to your yoga breath. 3 to 4 count inhale, 3 to 4 count exhale. So begin to make small movements with your wrists and your ankles. Opening and closing your hands a few times. On your next breath, gently bend your knees, bring your feet to the floor. Feel your whole entire back rest into your mat. Taking a moment here to think about something that you're grateful for today. Something simple. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, roll over onto your right side. Come into a fetal position. Your knees come into your chest. Your head can rest on your mat or on your arm. Taking a few minutes here as you seal in your yoga practice, allowing your nervous system to reset, gathering energy from your right side. On your next exhale, use both of your hands to make your way back up to a seated position. Bringing your hands up to your sides, palms face the ceiling. Inhale as you draw your hands up over your head, gathering in positive energy. Drawing that energy between the palms of your hands as you slide your hands down to heart center. Gently pressing your palms together, your thumbs gently rest into your sternum. Taking a moment here to honor yourself. Thank your body for its strength. Thank your mind for its strength. Thank yourself for practicing yoga today, for doing something good for yourself. As you continue through the rest of your day, try to focus on your breath. Your breath is a healing tool that you have with you at all times that we often forget to use. Thank you for letting me share your practice with you today. Namaste.